took no rest. He took no punishment. He took no shame. He took no guilt.
He took it all and he took it to the cross. He paid the price once for all for sin. He paid the price once for all. If we would only just receive his blood, if we would only realize that we were sinners before him, if we only realize our great need of Jesus, our great need of forgiveness, if we would only realize that we are wrong, that God is right, and that we need God, that we need his grace and his mercy, and we can only receive that through Jesus. We need to realize today, doesn't matter who you are or what you've got, without Jesus we stand condemned. Without Jesus we stand condemned. But please people, this is a message of hope. This is a message of love and forgiveness. This is a message of, this is good news. Hey, even though we're guilty,
I worship the devil.
Even though we're guilty and we're sinful people, if we would only put our trust and faith in Jesus Christ, what he done upon the cross, that the blood that he shed, that we can be washed whiter than snow, we can be forgiven, we can be saved. There's hope in Jesus. There's hope today in Jesus Christ. If we would realize him, if we would just, we would take him at his word, we would receive him as Savior. Whether you like it or not, Jesus is alive. Whether you believe it or not, Jesus is risen. Whether you know it or not, Jesus died for you. Whether you know it or not, Christ, the Son of God, died on a cross because of you, because of me, because of us. But please, people, today, know that Jesus is alive. 3 days later, he rose again. You can check historical records, you can check biblical records, you can check Jewish history, Roman history. Jesus Christ rose again from the dead, and you can't get away from it. That Jesus is alive, brother. That he's alive forevermore. What are we going to do about Jesus? Are we just going to ignore the message? Are we going to ignore him all our lives? Are we going to just live in our own ways, doing our own thing? Please, people, take heed today that Jesus, even though he loves you, he does not love your sin. He does not love your sin. We live every day just doing what we're doing, going to work, coming back, breaking the law of God every day. We break the law of God every day, but yet we realize, we think that we're not going to be held accountable. But one day, we will all be held accountable. We'll all be standing before God in judgment. Do you not realize today that the Bible says that there is a point for a man to die and after that to face judgment? What are we going to do? We need a Savior. We need someone to forgive us of our sins. And who is able to do that? There's no man, no man who is able to do that. There's no